What's happening, folks? Welcome back to Hopped Up Beer Review. Tonight, we have a special treat for you. We're going to one of my favorite breweries, and I have to thank my good friend Scott. We're going to go visit our friends at Burial Beer. And tonight, we're going to have a special beer from their Anno X selection called Until There Was Emptiness, Where There Was Once Something Left to Give. Stick around.
Hey, everybody, welcome to Hopped Up Beer Review, the show where we give your unprofessional and somewhat biased opinion about the beer we are drinking and reviewing. We are back to do that once again. Be sure to like, subscribe, and cheers that notification bell and leave some comments down below. We would definitely appreciate that feedback. I've got Andy in the attic. I've got Jay. I am Ben. What in the world are we drinking today?
Today, we are going to friends over at Burial, and we're going to have a unique one. I'm really excited to share this one with you guys. It's called Until There Was Emptiness, Where There Was Once Something Left to Get. It's a tipa. So let's crack and get drinking, because I know Ben's excited.
Man, I've not had this one before. Go ahead and throw that out there.
I should hope not.
No.
But I will say, I have had it before.
All right.
So.
That's delightful.
Cheers, mates.
Cheers, mates.
Just give me a moment. This is great.
Yeah. So, you know, this is, I guess I could fill in a little for you, Andy. You can cover Burial. We'll talk Burial Beer Company.
I've got some about it.
This came as part of what they called their Anno X series. So they were celebrating, obviously, their 10th year anniversary. And with that, they had a selection of 10 different beers that they called out for each year of being in existence. And this one so happened to be year number 8. It was I purchased it as a variety pack that included all of the beers. Now, some of them were 4-packs. Some of the years might have been a large bottle sour or a large bottle stout. So it was a mixture of all sorts of things, but it was an excellent purchase. So, Andy, would you like to lead in on Burial?
Yeah. Until There Was Emptiness, Where There Was Once Something Left to Give. Burial is known for their very long names to their beers. This is 10%.
And their can art.
Yes. 10% triple IPA. Kind of hazy triple IPA. 31 IBUs, which I'm actually surprised at the lower IBUs for a triple. So I'm going to read off, because on their can, it has QR code that will send you to their Anno X series and each year's. And they have a little video with it, but the descriptions of, they kind of recap their year, like you said. And this one, it just to explain the beer more, it's a triple. And it's based on a past beer called Dream Candy that they made. The earth as we now know it, the dissection, the vast landscape, heavy resin, all were stories to tell. And today it is the calming voice of dream candy that has carried us to a perpetual place of fondness. We dabbled in a coronation anthem for this series with this strong ale. This is so Burial, the way that they, their whole philosophy with beer and production and how to name it, the cycle of life and birth to death and burial, which is the, you know, to them, like the final process. So this is made of barley, oats, and candy sugars, infused with cryo and incognito hops. And it's triple dry hopped with a select array of Mosaic, Simcoe, and Eldorado, and then ultimately finished with Simcoe Cryo.
So, is this, we had previously had a Burial, but it didn't come through, right? The Surfwax was squishy.
Surfwax. And the other one we actually reviewed and released
is Shadow Clock.
Shadow Clock. Yeah. So if y'all want to know more about the history of Burial, Ben might put a link to Shadow Clock on this this review. So more about Burial. Burial Brewery is out of Nashville, North Carolina. It's a microbrewery. It's founded in 2013.
So going back to I had a question about the Anno series, if we know it. Are they releasing all 10 of these beers this year in as a ode to the past 10, or what?
That was my understanding. You know, they released them all like kind of at one time. So it was earlier in the year.
Gotcha.
Are a couple months old, three or four months old at max. I don't want to get much beyond that with the IPA.
Sure. So this one represents year 8 then. That's what we're saying. So There are 9 other basing beers.
This one was heavily based on their, as Andy referenced, their dream candy as the base of this. You know, we've talked about a little bit with Shadow Clock, some of their amazing can art. Obviously, their names, Surfax and Shadow Clock, are two of the shorter names you will run into. Most of them are typically like this one, where you have a long saying as a name. They're, as we covered earlier under Shadow Clock, they're historically known for really good IPAs and some heavy stouts and occasional sours. But right there in the artsy town of Asheville. So
take some good sips, because I want you to try and tell me what you taste, because I've got their description of tasting notes.
I think you're just trying to get me drunk, sir.
Maybe.
On this 10%er.
So, if you want to make a stab, fine, I'll go ahead and say it. So, see if you can. I thought this was pretty interesting. Sugar dusted berry gummies adorning a passion fruit pineapple frap alongside tropical Skittles.
Wow. I was just going to say that.
The passion fruit pineapple frap. That is exactly. But it's got a little creamy texture to it.
It does have a creamy flavor to it. You know, I could see some of the pineapple.
Yeah. The tropical, definitely tropical.
Well, you mentioned the candy sugar originally.
Sweet. Yeah.
And you know, that really, I get a lot of that now. After you mentioned that, I don't obviously wouldn't have pulled out the exact notes that you laid out there, but,
yeah, I was thinking more like maybe orange peel, or, you know.
The first few more sips generic. Were just amazing. Mm-hmm. Now I'm picking up on some of the hops in that bitter aftertaste a little bit. So this is not like a lot of the double and triple IPAs that we have where you get a big honey feel to it. This is that masks, excuse me, all the IBUs. The IBUs come out in this, every single one of them. There's no masking, but it's got a lot of floral effect.
But it's not a lot. I mean, at 31 IBUs, this is not, to me, it's not bitter at all. No. It almost has an orange pineapple juice flavor to it, more so than anything else.
It's got that great
balance. Maybe a little grapefruit. Yeah.
Sweet than the bitter. So it's pretty good.
Yeah. Well, go ahead and finish off and rate it for us, Andy.
Definitely great. And definitely, I think I'm getting more of the bitter as it warms up. So initially, those first few sips, I wasn't picking up much bitter. It was the cooler it was. It was very sweet, floral. You got that tropical citrus feel to it from the pineapple. And I'm glad it's not too candy sweet, because I don't like candy sweet in my beers that much. Not like a Tiny S's kind of situation, thankfully. So that's really good. I just wanted to also point out this artwork is banging. I like how, I need to go back to it, how it starts with your stained glass window intact, and then you go in, and within this coffin, you know, you've got the part of a skeleton. Of course, it's shown. Evidently, this has been there a while because things are growing through it. It's breaking down, but it's looking up skyward, and it's steamy, mystical. And then you continue around, and like you get to the other stained glass window, and it's fractured and things like that. So, with their long names and with their artwork, I like on this, because we didn't have this. I think I looked it up on Shadow Clock, but I didn't find the allegory. They actually wrote the allegory on this, and it says, an awakening in an afterlife. So I thought that was a pretty cool depiction of that, you know, within the coffin and all. So to me, stuff like this adds to the beer. So it's really good. So on the fence on this one. I'm gonna give it an 8.5. It's that good.
All right. So Jay has had this one. So per Hopped Up Beer Review tradition, I will go ahead and review. Otherwise, I would have made him go first. So, you know, throw the splash up, not the IPA guy. Whenever we get
your IPA thing. Tolerant guy now,
is that the new me? So I think the first couple of sips of this for me was very floral, almost, you know, perfumey. It was, you know, that was just, I really got a sense of, you know, almost like a potpourri. Even, I mean, it was just real floral. And it's calmed down for me a bit in that sense. And, you know, as I mentioned before, you mentioned the candied sugar ingredients. I get a lot of that now, but to your point, you know, you get kind of the bitter, and it kind of reminds me almost like a salted caramel, in a sense that it's, you get two kind of, you know, flavors that, you know, aren't supposed to kind of, don't necessarily always go together, but they make it go to, exactly, they blend it great. And so I think, you know, now that floral has calmed down for me, I really like it. First couple sips, I wasn't quite sure, but with the flavors that I'm getting now, man, this is actually really a really good beer. And it's really interesting how they have combined everything in it, because like you said, I would never have guessed, you know, Skittles and pineapple and, you know, pixie dust and whatever they sprinkled in this thing. But it works, and it's really, really good. Like you said, throw in the can art, it's really cool as well. I think for me, as kind of, again, not the IPA guy, I mean, this one's an 8 for sure. You know, very close to an 8.5 for me. But I'm going to stick with an 8. And I like it. Jay?
Well. So it's interesting. I actually had a burial last night and another one of my friends brought me, and it had another great name, you know, far too many demons to endure with cool can art. They knock it out of the park on their names and their can art and their creativity. I really want to go visit their brewery facility. They bought an old state park, I believe, outside of Asheville, and it's called Forestry Camp. And they even do like concert festivals where they invite other breweries to come in there every year. And that might be a hopped up beer review trip next time, but because they have a brew fest with 50 or 60 breweries that come in. This one to me is fantastic. It might have mellowed some over the months we've had it. I can't tell how much, but it's really good. It's one of the better IPAs, and you know, to me, I have to go higher. I gotta go 9.5.
Wow.
It's smooth
for you.
It's easy drinking, deceptive at 10%. We didn't really talk about that. I mean, you don't get alcohol coming through on this, and it's got the haze, the juice, the flocculants. I hear what you're saying with the floral perfume. That first sip or two, it's almost kind of like an orange juice or something, or a pineapple juice mixture. And it does, as it warms and it breathes, I think it kind of ages almost like a wine a little bit when it's open. So it's a good beer. I'm glad you two like it, but maybe not as much as me.
Definitely not a keg beer, Ben.
No, this would not be a keg beer for me. But no, definitely one though for me, I'd love to have again, you know, and man, I would love to have this on draft too, you know.
Yeah, me too.
So I think that would be great as well. All right, cue the fireworks. That is going to be an 8.7 for the Until There Was Emptiness, Where There Was Once Something Left to Give, from Burial, part of their Anno X, Anno 10, Anno X series. Definitely one that if you get your hands on, you find out in the wild, you have got to give a shot. If you've had it, you need to let us know what you think about it, because we're putting it on the Hopped Up Beer Review Wall of Fame. Anything above an 8.5 goes up there. And this one, deservedly so, has been added to the list as well. With that, be sure to like, subscribe, and cheers that notification bell. Definitely appreciate you guys checking out this video. Be sure to check us out on all social medias down below in the description. Come say hey in our Hopped Up Beer Review Discord server. We are there to talk about the name of this beer and other beer that we have as well. And lastly, if you have any interest in any Hopped Up Beer Review merch, we've got a link for that down there as well, like this t-shirt or some of the stuff that Jay is showing off there.
Yeah.
That's all we got for this one. Check it out if you have not done so. Thanks for watching this video. For Andy in the Attic and Jay, I am Ben. Cheers, mates.
Cheers, mates.
Cheers, mates.